Years ago, not long after Columbus sailed to America, Spain became the ruler of Mexico and other lands to the north, including what is now the Lone Star State of Texas. From far across the water, missionaries brought their wide-horned cattle, which later came to be known as longhorns, and their prized horses, and instructed the natives in their care and uses. The climate was so well suited and the prairie grasses so plentiful that it wasn't long before there were more animals than were needed. Many wandered away from the unfenced prairies in which they were grazing, formed into herds and bands, and lived wild on the fertile plains. By 1845, there were more than 3 million longhorns and almost 500,000 horses. The wild horses were called Mustangs. As so many others are doing, you may decide to stay in this rich wilderness and become a cattle hunter. Because most of the cow hunters were so young, they were spoken of as cowboys. You round up a herd, burn your own brand mark deep enough in each hide to make you the unquestioned owner, and then, you don't know what to do with them. They aren't easy to sell because the nearest large markets are far away, and it's impossible to get them there. Your wealth of livestock is worthless. This was the problem facing the early cattle owners after men like James Bowie, Davy Crockett, and Sam Houston had fought for and won freedom from Mexico. By the end of the Civil War in 1865, Texas was so poor that she just had to find a way to unlock her millions of cattle and turn them into new wealth.